stay.
Well, the researcher I spoke with says there's some real concern about where the fire is going to be 24 to 48 hours from now. So it is critical to study those thick black plumes of smoke you just saw from Live Copter 3 from the Caldor fire. Now, Assistant Professor Neil Lareau says plumes are a way fires create their own weather. All of that hot air rising up has to be replaced by inflowing air. Now, those fire-induced flames can create extremely erratic fire behavior and propel the fire very rapidly in one direction or another. Now, included in those plumes of smoke are embers and different debris, including burning trees. All of that being picked up in those flames, circling around in the air and landing some 2 miles away right now. And this is what causes spot fires. And the longer the distance these plumes travel, according to the professor, the more concerning.
We see really receptive fuels right now, meaning that when those embers fall, it's really easy for them to start a new fire. All that vegetation is extraordinarily dry. And then the big concern, both yesterday and today and even into tomorrow, are the winds. We're looking at kind of an alignment of these stronger southwest winds that are going to be developing and kind of crescendoing through the day today into tomorrow evening, including through the night tonight. And those winds are aligned with that kind of up canyon direction along US 50 over Echo Summit and off into the terrain, even by kind of Heavenly Ski area and stuff like that.
Lareau says data researchers use can help reveal when a fire is getting to a critical point, that it can produce long range spotting and dangerous fire induced winds. Reporting live tonight in the newsroom, Brittany Johnson, KCRA 3 News.